Today we're gonna talk about the geometry of modal interchange. Here's the overlay of the lecture. We will discuss about modal interchange. We will discuss the case of minor major interchange. Then we will discuss the worst thing that we can get, the worst geometrical shape we can get. Then we will discuss when we will get a decent shape, and then what shape we will get. What is modal interchange? Modal interchange is borrowing chords from a parallel mode, in that case minor. For example, in that case we are in C major and we borrow chords from C minor. You can see that the B half diminished is from the from C minor, and the F minor 7 is from C minor. I will give you some example to listen to. For example, hold on. For example, from video game music, because video game music is cool. Hold on. For example, you can see that we are in A minor, but this B flat comes from A Phrygian, so we have a borrowed chord. I will send you the link in the chat. You can listen to the last part, and I can play it on my piano. For example, if we are in A minor, we can borrow a chord from A Phrygian. You see that B flat comes from A Phrygian. You see, and in that example, we have a C major chord progression, but we have borrowed chord from the minor mode. So, is it understood for everyone? If it's understood, you can tell me in the Karen White, okay. You can write okay in the chat if it's understood. I have a question. So this modal interchange is only used for keys that have the same static note, like B minor or B Phrygian. Yeah, it's a parallel. It's not the relative, it's a parallel. So if you are, for example, if you are in C major, you borrow chords from C minor or C Phrygian, etc. It's a parallel. It's another mode, but it's a parallel scale. Got it, okay. So we have C major and C minor, but when you borrow chords from C minor, you actually borrow chords from E flat major, because E flat major is a relative major of C minor. So when you borrow chords from C minor, you actually borrow chords from E flat major. But what if we put this a little bit further? Like borrowing chords from the parallel minor scale of the parallel minor scale. You see? Does anyone have something to say? I heard something. I have some. I heard something. Okay. if you borrow chord from C minor, you're actually borrowing from E flat major. But what if we put this a step further? If you borrow chord from C minor, and then borrow a chord from the parallel minor scale of the parallel minor scale. And we can go on. If we borrow chord from C minor,
I think that was from grandma.
From E flat major,
where is it?
And then we borrow a chord from E flat minor.
Still downstairs.
G flat major, but G flat major. We can borrow a chord from the parallel minor scale of the parallel minor scale of the parallel minor scale. And then we can do this forever because we'll get back to where we started because C minor is a minor relative of E flat major. E flat major, we go to E flat minor. It's the same thing of G flat major. It's the same. If we go to parallel minor scale, we get F sharp minor scale. It's the same thing of A major. And then we get to the parallel minor scale. And then this parallel minor scale is the same thing of C major. Basically, it's a model. It's model borrowing of model borrowing of model borrowing of model borrowing. Do you get it? You can write OK in the chat if you get it, because it's very important. Oh, OK. I will explain it once again to be sure. If we are C major and we borrow chord from C minor, we're actually borrowing from E flat major. But if we borrow chord from the parallel minor scale of the parallel minor scale, we can go. We could borrow chord from E flat minor, and then E flat minor is the same thing as G flat major. And if we borrow chord from the parallel minor scale, it's F sharp minor. And F sharp minor is the same thing as A major, and if we borrow chord from the parallel minor scale, it's A minor, and then we come back to C major. What's the worst thing that we can get with this way of thinking? The worst thing that we can get is a two-sided shape. For example, the integral between Phrygian and minor. Why? Let me explain. Why do we have four sides on the minor-major interchange? Because to go from the first step to the second step, we added three half steps. To move from one step to another, we added three semitones. If we added three semitones, then we'll have to do four steps to get back to where we started, since 3 times 4 equals 12, and we have 12 semitones in the chromatic scale. We have some questions in the chat. Whispers to Shade ask, so we can actually borrow from any of those randomly? Not randomly, but a good use would be to stay on one side. You know, you can see that as a square, and you can a good use is, for example, to move clockwise, like going to C major, to A minor, to F sharp major, to E flat major, to C major. Does this answer your question, Whisper to Shade? Yeah, get it, okay. Diaporama. Why do we have a square? Like I said, from one step to another, we add three semitones, so we have to do four steps to get back to where we started. But with Phrygian and minor, we add seven semitones, but seven is not a divider of 12 and not the multiple of a divider of 12. So to get back to where we started, we You have to do 12 steps. Is it understood? Yeah.
Correct.
HK, it's that going around the entire circle of thief.
Yes.
Yeah, it's like going around the entire circle of death. Sorry, I have a huge, a massive French accent, sorry. So, like I said, the fission minor item challenge will lead us to the entire circle of fifth, and then we have two 12-sided shape. Albin is writing something. Yeah. So is it understood that the fact that if we go, if we use Phrygian minor interchange, we it won't work the same way as minor major interchange because we move by 7.5 steps by steps. Is it understood? No? Ah, yep. Yeah, it would be very jarring. It would be very jarring, and it's completely unusable. With Phrygian, this way of thinking can be applied to Phrygian minor interchange. But that leads us to the following point: when will we get a decent shape? To get a decent shape, we need to move by a divisor of 12 or the multiple of a divisor of 12 on each step. Let's label the mode with numbers. For example, Ionian 0, Dorian 2, Phrygian 4, because I use the chromatic scale. If we put X is the main mode and Y is the mode where it broke forms, the condition to have a decent shape are this one. I will explain them. You have to have a multiple of a divisor of 12 or the multiple of a divisor of 12. So this is the condition. But I grouped them because 9 is a major sixth, and it's the inversion of a minor third. So the two first conditions are equivalent. Then I will check the chat. So these are the condition to have a decent shape. You have to have a divisor of 12 or the multiple of a divisor of 12. For example, Mixolydian Lydian. We have 7 minus 5, it's 2, it's okay. Phrygian minor. You have 4 minus 3 equals 7. Why did I put minus 3 and not 9? Because It's the same thing actually, because if we start on C that is 0, A is actually minus 3 because you it's on the left of C. So it's the same thing as 9. I'll check if any no questions. Phrygian major, we have 4 minus 0, it's okay. And Lydian major, we have 5 minus 0, 5, and that is not okay. What shape will we get? If we have 2, we will get an hexagon, 4 a triangle, 3 a square, and 6 a line. I will explain. If we move by 2 semitones on each step, we'll have to have 6 steps to get back to where we started. So 6 sides, so an hexagon. If we move by 3 semitones on each step, we have to do this 3 times to get back to where we started, so we have a triangle. And if we have 3 semitones per steps, we have to do 4 steps to get back to where we started, a square. And if we have 6 semitones per step, we have to do this 2 times to get back to where we started. Is it okay so far? Write here in the chat if it's okay for you. Oh, I will repeat myself. Sorry. Okay, I will explain. I didn't make myself clear, so I will. HK, you got it. Yeah, it's exactly that. But not everyone got it, so I will explain it one more time. Tac. Picture yourself the chromatic scale. C is 0. C sharp is 1, D is 2, D sharp is 3, E is 4, etc. So we label the notes. I use this labeling in my lecture about modular arithmetic. So if you put, like, if the Phrygian is the mode built on E, so we can put it as 4. The Lydian is 5 because it's the mode built on F. The Mixolydian is 7, etc. That's the numbers. Yeah, he will always be 4. It's the label from the chromatic scale, so it works with all the scales. It's from the chromatic scale. Is it okay now, Whisper to Shade? Okay. Someone is writing something. Okay. So, Whisper to Shade is writing something.
Mm-hmm.
Guys, sorry, but I'm waiting for Whisper to change message. Message. I don't know how to pronounce it. Oh no, it's not exactly that. You have to look at your scale. If you borrow, you have to not the note of those chords, but the note of where does that chord come from. For example, if you are in minor and you use a chord from Dorian, you have to count from A to D, because minor is the A mod and D and Dorian is the D mod. So you have to count from A to D. You have to look to check where does that chord come from. For example, if I for example, I use I'm in C minor and I borrowed a chord from C Dorian. So you have to count from A to D, because you are in minor and minor is and you borrow a chord from Dorian, so you have to count from A to D. Yeah, HK got it. Yeah, it's 5. Yeah, that's exactly that. Yeah, it's ouch. It's ouch because it's not a divider of 12. So we have the conditions. Maxoidian Lydian, okay. Fujian minor, ouch. Fujian major, okay. Lydian major, ouch. So the shape. If we have a two between the two mods, we have an hexagon, because if you move by 2 semitones on each steps, you have to do 6 steps to get back to where we started. If you have 4, it's a triangle. If you have 3, it's a square. And if you have 6, it's a line. Examples. Fujian major. I think that we will get it in an example. If we are in C Fujian and we borrow chord from C major, the C major is E Fujian. And if we borrow chord from the parallel major scale, it's E major, but E major is G sharp Fujian. But G sharp Fujian is A flat major, and A flat major is C Fujian. Do you get it with this little example? Okay. Does everyone get it? You can write okay in the chat if you get it. Whisper to Chase is writing something. Yeah. Whisper to Chase ask, just an idiot check, we're talking about scales. Yeah, it's that. You got it. Another example. Another example. Lydian Locrian. If you are on C Lydian, you borrow chords from Locrian, you're actually borrowing from F sharp Lydian. But if you borrow from the parallel Locrian scale of this Lydian scale were actually borrowing from Cilician. You know, Cilician is one sharp, Cilocrian is seven sharp, the seven sharp is F sharp Lydian. We borrow from the parallel Locrian scale of this Lydian scale, F sharp Locrian, but F sharp Locrian is one sharp, and one sharp is Cilician. Do you get it? Do you understand this example? Yeah, whisper to Chad. Yeah, and now we will talk about some examples in actual songs because music is meant to be listened to. So, for example, a song is "My Time" by Bowen. I will send you the song. Fucking ad. I will send you the song. And I will send you the lead sheet. So you can. The lead sheet with the hexagon. So you can listen to the song and look at the lead sheet and check out the hexagon. It's an hexagon. And you can feel the modulation and the changes in the song. I will give you a few seconds to listen to and to look at the sheet and we will talk about it. You can write okay in the chat if you feel the modulation in it. If you feel the changes in it. So basically, we start in F major, then we move clockwise, no, anti-clockwise on the circle. It's like HK as before, it's we're going around the circle in this song for most of it. We start off F major, then we borrow a chord from E flat, then from D flat, then from B, then from A, and then it's there is a complicated thing. But the first part follows the circle. It moves around the circle. It moves around the circle. Whisper to Jade is writing. Yeah. You got it. Does anyone have a question? Because I don't have much more to say. Does anyone have a question about this concept? It's a good question, you know, Sima, but it's a bit complicated, but actually, an hexagon is two triangles mixed together. So you can also move by the side of the triangle. That's why you have a triangle in the hexagon. It's actually two triangles combined together, the hexagon. Does anyone else has a question? Yes. I can also play some examples, like yes, that's very cool. Like, for example, what I did is that I borrowed a chord from the Dorian mode. Like, I started on C minor, and this F major comes from the Dorian mode, and it adds a nice mood to the song because it's a major chord, and it's very common to borrow the fourth chord from the Dorian mode. For example, Inosino is waiting to say. So do the mod apply to minor scales, or do you think about things in major? So do the other mod apply to minor scales, or do you only think about things in major or from the roots? No. You can have an interchange between any modes. You can have an interchange between a major mode and a minor mode, a minor mode and a major mode, or both. For example, if you are on C major, I started on the C major. I borrowed the chord from the Lydian mode. So you can have an interchange between any mode, between Phrygian, Dorian, and Lydian, Mixolydian, and Lydian. You can have an interchange between any mode. Anyone else has a question? If not, I will end the lecture. So thank you for listening to me, to my very unbearable Frenchy accent. Sorry for that. Sorry about that. Thank you for listening.
And I hope that it can help you to think more about Moz and modal attention.